Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. Commissioner Raisa Jajuri, the Chairman of Committee on Fiscal. Commissioner Talib Binito. Commissioner Abdullah Kamlian. Commissioner Pedreto Esma. Commissioner Froilan T. Mendoza. Commissioner Hussein P. Munoz. Commissioner Fatma T. Salapuddin. Melanio Olama. Then Commissioner Ibrahim Ali, Commissioner Said Sheikh. Then out of 8 members, there are 6 commissioners are present and 2 are not available. So there is a quorum. And we have 2 commissioners act as observer.
Okay, so there being a quorum, we now call the session to order.
Good afternoon po. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Personally, I may not be the worthy person to speak before you, but I rise up today to speak for an in behalf of the Sultan of Baloy, the Sultanate of the Municipality of Baloy, and who bestowed upon me the authority to deliver the message and, if possible, to express their sentiment by way of resolution, of which I am asking to be allowed to read this resolution. Resolution requesting the intervention of the Secretary Jing Belis of the Office of the Presidential Advisor of Peace Process, the chairman of the government panel, the MNLF Peace Panel, Professor Miriam Coronel Ferrer and Muhajir Iqbal, MILF Panel Chairman, to look into the possibility of integrating the entry of the Sultanate traditional leadership in the proposed basic law of the Bangsamoro government. Whereas the Sultanate leadership of the Sultans in the affairs of the national government and the proposed Bangsamoro government has been neglected, thus much for recognition. In fact, the Sultanate were not subdued by the Spain for more than 370 years was because of the leadership of the Sultanate system of government. And if the fight for the American, for the Japanese, was again because of their unity and maratabat as one people with one system of tarikib and ijma and Islam as their way of life. The sultans, like the Sultan of Kudarat of Maguindanao, the Sultan Alonto of Ramain, the Amay Manabilang of Marawi, Dato Kadir Amay Pakpak, Sultan Pandapatan, and Sampurna of the famous Padang Karbala, the Battle of Bayang, the Sultan Grandi of Magadar, Sultan Amirul of the Battle of Bacolod, the Sultan Jamilul Kiram of Sulu, the Zamboanga Declaration, and the 120 signatories of the Dansalan Declaration are sultans and datos who registered their objection for their annexation or inclusion in the Mindanao and Sulu in the Philippine Commonwealth Republic. These are the sultans who died and fought against the foreign conquistadores. No republic, no freedom of fighter that fought for the maratabat of the Bangsamoro homeland except the sultans as a freedom fighters and a leaders. If you recall, Luzon and Visayas in those years of the Spanish regime was ruled by the Muslim datos, rajas, and they are the sultans in their original form. Whereas the Federation of Royal Sultanate of Lanao, composed of 11 sultanate leagues, where the 16 royal houses of Lanao, the 28 legislative assembly, and the four sultanates that take care of the boundary of the four principalities, Patapulampung of Lanao, and the different organizations are members of the prestigious organization are now seeking for the recognition and integration of sultans in the national body politics and in the, and that will be Bangsamoro government. Since time and immemorial, sultans ruled for many years up to this time. The sultan powerful authority cannot be denied or objected by anyone. In fact, among their functions as governed and authorized by the Taritiban Ijma called for the following: the settlement of reduce, the dispute arising from the domain shall be the disposal decision. He is the titular head and is the crowning role in the KA is the care, the concern, love and protection of his people. He holds the power giving, giving orders and commands in either the doing or not doing of all an acts in his people. He has the final say in all acts passed upon by the policy makers, the Bubayaku Taritib, and his council or the advisor. He approved anything brought to him, for the decision encompasses all things in his domain, and say to it that his people are protective and encourage people in his domain to work. Everything proper in consonance with the Taritib, Ijmas, the Sharia law. Today, subconstitutionally function their duties and responsibility with the flying color as head high. Whereas the framework agreement and the power sharing including the other annexes duly approved by DRP and IMINILEP negotiating panel has no definite article and the section that integrate the recognition of the sultanate into the body politics and recognition with peace and development of the Bangsamoro homeland or the Muslim Mindanao in particular. In the concluded framework agreement under part 3 about power number 6 state, and I quote, the customary rights and tradition of indigenous people shall be taken into consideration in the formation of the Bangsamoro's judicial system. This may include the recognition of indigenous processes as alternative modes of dispute resolution. If the GRP MILA panel is thinking of the indigenous people or indigenous processes, as the sultanates is a part of the whole of the indigenous people, is wrong to interpret, because the sultanate is a system where the sultan is the titular head and who role and who provide in the Taritiban Ijma, particularly the four principalities of Lanao, the Patapungampog, while indigenous people within the system ruled by sultan as far as Muslim Mindanao is concerned. Take case of the Sultan of Romain and Dusan, the Sultan of Masio, the Sultan of Baloi, the Sultan of the East and West of Punayan, and the race of the 16 royal houses of Lanao, like the Pagayawan, Bayang, Butig, Maribu, Bacolod, Minitapad, Burukut, Bansayan, Taporag, Rugan, and the Malundong, County Mayor, Councilors, and Barangay Chairman, object and look down the power and the authority of the Sultan? Absolutely it cannot. In the same way, the Sultan of Maguindanao, the Sultan of Sulu, the Sultan of Barangays, and how much more for mere indigenous people like indigenous people, Allahu Akbar. The Malaysian government, the Brunei government recognizes the entry of the sultanate rule in the respective government as embodied in the respective constitution, and this we may propose as it be studied as a pattern steps towards the recognition of the sultanate rule in the system of government that we are about to adopt. Hence, it is not too late for its inclusion and adoption in the basic law now in the process written by the 15-man Transitory Commission. Wherefore, it is hereby resolved, it is hereby resolved that the following consider for the recognition and approval of the national government and in the proposed Bangsamoro government to wait. Number one, the Federation of the Sultanate, Royal Sultanate of Lanao, recognized by the national government as its partner in the promotion of peace and development and in the Bangsamoro homeland, providing fund budget thereat. Two, integrating the rule of the Sultan leadership
on the ongoing writing of the Basic Law by the Transitory Commission patterning the way the Malaysian and the Brunei government does the significant role of the sultans in the building of in the nation building. Number three, institutionalizing the sultanates as a permanent unit of the national government and the Bangsa Moro-Omlo in the pursuing their agenda for peace and development. Fourth, the copy of the resolution be furnished to the Excellency Benigno Aquino III, President of the Republic of the Philippines, Tengku Dato A.B. Gaphar, Tengku Muhammad Malaysian Facilitator, Yusik Hasmin Busran Lau of the Office of the Presidential Assistant on Muslim Concern, the Chairman of the 15-man Transitory Commission, and the Chairman of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front for their consideration and approval, signed February 10, 2014, in the city of Marawi, signed Sultan Muhammad Saaluddin Talib Lumondot, Secretary General, Sultan Sabansayan, approved by Sultan Mahmud Dalidig, President, Sultan Sapagayawan, attested Sultan Mulansing Makabando, be a Board of Director Chairman, Sultan Samarinaot. Thank you very much. Mabuhay ang Bangsa Moro.